way. But it used to be mind-boggling when I did the TV show, and every week for 3 years, mm-hmm. I was working with an icon, and you would do it. It's about the music and the work, and then mm-hmm. afterwards you go, I can't believe I just did that. Yeah. So, but anyway, I got introduced to him, and he was introduced to me, and then it just very, like, that switch went off again, and it was two musicians talking.
Yeah.
Like you and I are talking right now, and it's got to be that way, or you're paralyzed. You lose complete objectivity, and you can't do your job. So, with the greatest respect, it was just musician to musician, and we got along great. He was delightful, and the band was happy to have somebody there sort of in their team. Mm-hmm. They felt more comfortable, and it allowed the director to get these wonderful shots of them, and with the director saying, I need the drummer to do something interesting because I want to feature him, so I wrote that into the arrangement. Mm-hmm. So we did that, and it was just incredible. And then a week later, we come back and go right back to Capitol Studios again to work with the amazing Dave Grusin and Alan Bergman. Alan and Marilyn Bergman wrote the lyric for the closing song in the movie.
Yeah,
Dave Grusin wrote the song, the melody, and the chords, and did this wonderful arrangement.
God, it was fun to see him. I haven't seen him for a long time. It was like, wow.
It was fantastic. And that same thing with all the hats and what is my role as a producer, it changes, and it changes on the fly. A day before the session, Dave called me up and said, can you bring your guitar to the session? I think I want to have guitar on the arrangement. And I said, I would love to. Because when we first started working together and collaborating via long distance on the phone and emails, you know, I said, I'm happy to play guitar. I'd be thrilled to play guitar, but it's not a requirement. Mm-hmm. So if you don't have guitar in the arrangement, great. I've got plenty to do. Whatever you need, let me know. My job was to serve him. He's one of the artists also. And I said, and also if you decide that you want to have Dean or Lee or, you know, the guys that he has on his records, I said, those are my friends too. I wouldn't be offended. Mm-hmm. So be comfortable. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't want this to be awkward in any way. So he said, that's great. Thanks. I'll keep it in mind. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. And as a matter of fact, I recommended to the director of the movie that not only that we asked Dave if he would want to play piano on the session, but if he would do the arrangement. Because originally I was the arranger-producer for the music for the, mm-hmm. the movie, but it's like the director, in a rare moment of integrity, not for Danny Gold, but for the movie industry mm-hmm. and TV industry, actually asked me how I felt about something, which doesn't happen very often. And he just said, I have a question. I don't mean to offend you in any way, but what would you think about Dave Grusin, you know, doing the arrangement for the movie? And can I use profanity in this?
Oh, no.
And I said, are you fucking kidding? I just said, he's Dave fucking Grusin. I said, I was going to suggest that he do the arrangement to you, because who would do it better than the person who wrote the song? And I said, as a matter of fact, why don't we ask him if he'll play piano? You know, so that's how that all came about. So it was a mind-boggling experience, and one that I'm supremely and eternally grateful for, to have the opportunity, because we don't, as artists, we don't always get the opportunity just to go up and to show up and mm-hmm. do the things that we've trained so hard, you know, our whole lives to do, and using all our, not just our, well, certainly our gift and our natural talent, but mostly the hard work and the mm-hmm. hours and hours and the knowledge that we've accumulated. You know, by working with great engineers and, you know, you have been a guide to me through our career as well, because you've taught me a lot about gear. As long as we've been friends, you've taught me about guitar, we've taught each other things, we've worked together, and, you know, we learn together and we share information, and that's why I would never walk in and say, these are the mics that I use. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't have a mic locker full. Mm-hmm. You know, when I thought I had a really good mic. I had the 414 that I bought from you years ago. And then when I finally built my studio and you said, now you need to buy a really good microphone. It's like, I thought I had one. So we picked, you know, another great mic and preamps and things like that. So I've learned along the way from having great guides. And I thank you for that, because you have never steered me wrong.
No, thanks.